Aloha everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome back to another unboxing video. Today we're going to have a look inside a Kickstarter box that I have here. This is from the Kickstarter called The Iron Crows of Kazuk Iril. Now this was put on by a company I believe called Durgan Forge Games. And very cool looking Kickstarter. Excited to get into this thing. Can't lie, I've already looked at it once. But I do want to share it with you guys and show you exactly what's inside. I backed at a very small pledge level on this just to get a couple of miniatures, so that I could show you guys kind of what the quality of the miniatures were and what this new company is about. So I have three models here, and we'll go through each one of them in turn. Let's start with the most simplistic one, and that is this doggy miniature here. I believe, if I'm not mistaken, though don't quote me on this, that this model is a bonus model given away free for the Kickstarter. I believe I only actually ordered two miniatures. Maybe there. That's a good focus level. But you can see very cute little bulldog miniature there. Very nice. Mold lines are almost non-existent. There is a minor mold line. Let me see if I can angle it just so you can kind of see it. It runs right there. I don't know if you can see it quite. And you might be able to barely see just a hint of a highlight right there where the line kind of catches the light. I get rid of some of the light. Can you see it? No, it just disappears completely if I do that. It's very faint. It runs basically right there, though. You can kind of see it right in that little crevice in the arm, and then kind of coming up here on the arm, you can see it just a little bit. But for the most part, you can actually see it real nice right there. Right there on the back haunches. Very, very simplistic, leading into that little spaghetti strand air vent area. Very simple mold line, though. I mean, super, super clean model. Very little in the way of cleanup work, it looks like. So we'll set that one aside back in his container. And move on to the next. The next one, let's do this guy. This is a... not quite sure what this is. We'll find out here. I selected a couple of kind of neat looking miniatures basically here. So we have, let's see here. What do we have? Okay, so that's how it goes. All right, so we have sort of a dwarven commander style miniature here. You can see he's got some really good braiding in the beards. Very nice scale mail armor down here. Real long, bushy beard here. Very cool. He's got this very nice looking wolf pelt draped over his back and his shoulder with the actual face of the wolf kind of coming down over the left shoulder here. Really, really nice looking figure. His left arm is attached to the sprue here. I thought when I first got this, he was flipping somebody the bird, but no, that's just a vent. It's keyed in with a square key here for the shoulder socket, or for the elbow socket. So you just put it right in there. And very, very simplistic looking fit up. You can see here, I like this. You see those little crevices on the arm right there, very nicely divoted in. That actually lines up with some of the scale mail over here, so it makes the arm fit better with the miniature. Very well done. That's a sign of a nicely done miniature when you see models like that. And then over here we have the model's right hand, sort of holding this axe kind of on the ground by its head. The axe, I don't think you're going to be able to see it, but there are a few little runes in the axe. Let me see if I put it down as far as it can go. And it just gets blurry. There's no way I can show you the runes. I wish I could, but well, you can kind of see them. Let me see if I can zoom. You can sort of see them right there. They're just these little swirls on the axe. Just barely you can pick them up from the light. That will probably pick up nicely once I apply a wash to the axe in the affected area. But overall, very cool. And then you have the sort of the side. You can see he's got part of his cape attached to him here. But then you have this extra piece of the cape attached to the sprue. And that just keys in right here into this key on the side, like so. just sort of continues the cape around the arm, which is very, very nice. Not quite sure what this is. I would assume it's a top knot. It is. Look at that. There's a key right there, a nice little square hole into which you can insert this piece here and give him a nice little spiky bit of hair coming off the top of his head. Very cool. Again, minimal mold lines. In fact, on this guy, quick cursory glance, I don't see any. I think this is a drop cast miniature, though, based upon how the sprue looks. So that would be why there are no mold lines. There's a few on the axe, just going around the axe, but nothing major at all. What I will do, I'll take one of these models, not quite sure which one, and just see if I can get the mold lines off very quickly on a couple of areas and just see how the plastic or resin reacts to my cleanup process. But before we do that, let's move on to the third miniature that I have here. Okay, you can see we have here sort of a more grizzled veteran-style dwarf here. Very cool looking. Get rid of some of that light from the top side there. You can see very, very, very cool. Got a couple of like monocular eyepieces there. Very sort of a craggy nose and a craggy skull. Really lots of scarring on this model. Beard is not quite as long as the last guy's, but still very cool. And he's got this very neat hide that he's using as a cloak. Has some ribbing on the back of it back here. And that's because that hide actually belongs to a giant lizard. Look at that. That is very, very cool. And if memory serves me correctly, this actually kind of fits over his head like this. So it sort of goes down into the spine of that lizard there. So he's wearing this whole lizard pelt as a cloak. It's almost a dinosaur-like appearance. Amazingly cool look to this model. Very, very, very nice. Over here we do have the left arm or the left hand of the miniature. It's not actually holding the sword haft. It actually presses the sword. I'm sorry, the sword scabbard, up against the body here. You can see that it's not actually being held in the hand. It's just a convenient place for that scabbard to be, so that when you do attach the hand to the body, the scabbard comes out of the area that it's supposed to be in. Very cool spikes on the back of the hand. There on the back of the gauntlet for the hand. Really cool. Reminds me of Shredder from Ninja Turtles. Very nice. And then the right arm of our miniature is a nice little harpoon gun style weapon, sort of, if I remember correctly again, get off the model there, sort of braced over the shoulder like so, but you can kind of see it, sort of the rough idea of how it would work. And you can see it's a very cool looking gun there, sort of shoots these harpoons with a rope attached to it so he can maybe transfer from one area to another by rope. Very cool. And so neat model. And then we have yet another sword here. That one is keyed on the back with a square key, and that one will attach over here on this side. Very cool. Again, just checking for mold lines. Don't really see any massively jumping out at me, which is great. Even on the secondary sprues, very little in the way of mold line work removal. So I'm liking what I'm seeing there. The biggest mold lines that I saw really were on the dog. So let's transfer back over to him, and I will see how easily they remove with a hobby knife. And we'll go from there. Now, I will say, and you may have noticed, I don't know, the one thing that I'm really, that's so far a negative for me is, and I'll go ahead and pull this out of the box. Jeez, you can see there are no bases for these miniatures. It's just the model, so you're required to provide your own bases, at least at the time of the filming of this video, which is a little bit annoying, I admit, but not so much that it would turn me off of this line. Okay, so back here, it's probably the most prominent one. You can see that one really, really nicely. I'm going to try to get rid of that by doing just a simple scrape technique and see if the plastic or resin frays at all. It does not appear to be fraying, which is a sign of a decent quality plastic / resin. Not quite sure what these are. I think they're resin. Yeah, Yeah, that's a very, very good quality material right there. I like that. Cleaned up very, very nicely. You can see it didn't really leave any fuzzy areas. You can actually see the area where I have done the cleanup, but texture-wise, that feels really fantastic. Feels nice and smooth. Great cleanup process, I think, is what I'm going to experience with these miniatures. But overall, really cool. And you can see, I mean, just the level of detail in these miniatures is amazing. The quality is really, really good from what I can tell here. As I said, to me, the one drawback that I see is that, at least in the Kickstarter process, the models that I have here did not come with any bases. So that is one drawback to me, probably the only drawback. Very cool looking miniatures though otherwise, and would definitely recommend this line very, very much so. I will link to Durgan Forge's website down in the video description because unfortunately they did not put it on the box here, so I can't show it to you guys. But if you like this line, there's a huge, huge, huge line of dwarves that they did this Kickstarter for. There's probably, if I had to guess, at least 50 different dwarves. What you see here is just a very small sample. But the line is very nice looking, and if the quality of the miniatures and the detail of the other miniatures is the same as these models, then I can definitely recommend picking them up. You cannot go wrong with this line. It's really, really fantastic. And I hope that you will swing by Durgan Forge's website and give them a look. Again, this has been a look inside the Iron Crows of Kazuk Iril, one of my Kickstarter backing campaigns here. And I hope you guys have enjoyed it. It's been a fun unboxing, and hopefully you guys found something that you liked, and if you're a Dwarven player in whatever game that you have, maybe you'll find some miniatures that you might like as well. Again, the link for Durgan Forge's website is down there in the video description. Check it out and send some business their way. That's all I got for you guys today. If you happen to have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions, and make sure to click that bell icon so that you get notified every single time a new video gets posted. Thank you once again for watching. God bless you all. Have an amazing rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.